My name is Industry and Development of the DPI, and please be assured that DPI will continue to promote this industry, and we fully agree with the observations of the gentleman from Paranaque on the limitless potential of this industry. And we hope that one of these days, Your Honor will be percolating again, maybe in another house. Maybe by that time we would have been already number one in this chart.
Mr. Speaker, I'll go to my next chart. There is a projection, a forecast, and this came out in one of the major newspapers, Philippine Stars, saying, and it's the palace being quoted here, that by the end of 2010, the PPO jobs would reach 1 million. May we know from the DTI whether this is something that they can bet their budget on? 1 million level by the end of 2010?
Mr. Speaker, I've read some of the statistics from DTI. I hope and pray that that could be reachable, but it seems to be a little optimistic based on the statistics, on the numbers that we have here in DTI.
Well, being quoted here is no less than Malacanang. For example, it says here, a palace statement said that though BPO started the country in the 1990s, the industry really took off shortly after President Arroyo assumed power in 2001. There were 400,000 workers as of February 2009. It is estimated that by 2010, available jobs will be 900,000, despite the ongoing global economic slowdown. This is dated September 21, practically 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Mr. Speaker, I think the Business Process Association, the association of the various companies, I think of course would like to be as optimistic as they can, and I believe that those numbers came from them and given to the president. But per records and statistics from the DPI, a more realistic number would probably be more around the 600,000 figure.
No, we're talking 2010, the president already mentioned 600,000 by the end of 2009 in Arizona.
But for 2009, we would be in our statistics.
I remember that very clearly because I was surprised when she mentioned 600,000, because the last briefing before she delivered Arizona was 372,000. But then when I checked, 600,000 was by the end of 2009. In other words, we're talking here of an industry that is growing at a very rapid rate.
Mr. Speaker, those figures were given to the President by the Business Process Outsourcing Association. It didn't come from the DPI.
But it's the President's message, distinguished sponsor, Mr. Speaker.
Well, unfortunately, there needs to be a reconciliation of the numbers, but those figures were not from the department, Your Honor.
But thank you. Well, we're talking of the bright prospects, but of course, there are challenges. And in my next slide, the headline is negative perception of army threatens BPO peers. Negative perception. And this is especially in regard to our global competitiveness ranking. And I remember there was another ranking just a few days ago where we went down a little bit. Maybe we know how the DTI is going to address this. It says here, according to results of a survey conducted by the Business Process Outsourcing, Business Processing Association of the Philippines and Outsource to Philippines, persistent negative publicity are exacting a toll on the country's image vis-a-vis foreign investors?
Mr. Speaker, it's correct that I think we know that there are some negative perceptions about the Philippines, and that's a problem not just for DTI and the government, but also for the House, for all of us. But suffice to say that we do have a National Candidates Council that is working on these very issues. How to make the country more competitive. And if you allow me, I can briefly summarize some of the thrust that the Council has undertaken. In terms of human resource, there are priorities in terms of improvement of proficiency in English, science, and math. There's also what we call mentoring the mentors. Government sector initiative where DepEd provides scholarships for teachers who are non-science and math majors teaching science and math subjects. But we have what we call private sector feeding program to address the dropout rate. We have what we call recertified achievement of good governance standards in priority professions governed by the PRC. We also have we're addressing developing programs to help cities and municipalities achieve more class performance. There's also some work in terms of simplifying getting permits, licenses, and things of that nature. So, as Your Honor knows, the government is also trying as much as it's able in terms of addressing infrastructure requirements, because that's also an issue.
And this is some kind of a council. Which departments are represented in this council? And is the DTI the lead department in this council? Is it a sponsor?
Yes, that's correct. The National Competitive Council is the lead government entity there is the DTI. There are also private sector representatives. We'd be more than happy to provide Your Honor a more comprehensive report on the council and its workings and the accomplishments and the future thrust and programs.
Yes, I'd be very happy to have that because if I may continue, this survey says, according to the results, 51% of respondents indicated that negative perception of the country is ranked either as first